If you have an emergency in your home tonight, you might go to the first aid kit for yourself. But what do you do when your family pet needs medical help? Eyewitness News 5's Sophia Reza shows you what you can and can't have in the pet first aid kit.
Just like any pet, you never know what your dog can get into. Paul Borges has brought Stormy in to see the doctor. Stormy is like his child.
Great companion in all this, and she just needs somebody to take care of her, so I'll take care of her.
And just like any parent, Paul keeps a medical book for Stormy because
it tells you how you put antiseptic on it and clean them up so you don't have time to the vet all the time.
But when it comes to scratches, bites, and other small problems, what can you keep in a first aid kit for your pet? Veterinarians say it is somewhat similar to a first aid kit for you. The basics are bandage material, sticky tape, non-sticky tape, antiseptics like hydrogen peroxide to clean a wound, forceps or tweezers, first aid creams like Neosporin, and here's another good thing.
Children's liquid Benadryl. Okay, it's an antihistamine. It's excellent to keep around for your pets, especially your dogs, that have like insect stings, have allergic reactions to things.
It's good for itchy dogs as well, but you have to be careful how much you give your dog, so call your veterinarian before you give it to your pet. What you want to keep out of the first aid kit,
the Tylenols, the ibuprofens, the aspirins, stay away from those drugs. Those drugs in doses, high doses, can be toxic to your animals.
What if your pet has an upset stomach?
Some people will talk about using Pepto-Bismol to help settle the stomachs and things of that nature. And you need to be careful using those because some of these products contain some aspirin-like things in there.
Again, the best advice is to call your veterinarian. Paul knows it. Stormy may as well. Okay, and so will you.
Now, you can buy pet first aid kits online, but you can save some money just by making one yourself and then checking with your veterinarian just to make sure it's all safe.